Hi, my name's Katrina and I'm going to demonstrate our Batik expired painting kit. I've printed out this design, but if you're drawing your own, you just want to make sure that you go over it with a black sharp texture so that you can, when you lay your sheet over top, see the picture through the sheet.
Lay that on top into the position that you want. Take your line paste and just go over, trace over the image. I'd start from the top so that as you're working down, you don't smudge your work. When you're doing this, you just want to make sure there's no breaks in your lines. Otherwise, when you're painting, the paint will seep through. You want to try and get your lines as even as possible. This bottle that I'm working with now is the first bottle that we're trialing. I've since got new bottles that I will be testing before we launch our kits. The nozzle's great for fine, accurate lines, but it does make it a little bit difficult for children to squeeze out. So we'll test on bottles. So the bottles that come in the kit will look, most likely look a little bit different to these ones.
For children under the age of 7 or 8, you're going to want very simple designs for them to work on. I would actually even suggest patterns. Let them draw some patterns, circles, squares. You might want to overlap them. And just use 2 to 3 colours, 3 colours at the very most. Older children could work on something simple like this. If you're a confident drawer, you're most welcome to draw straight onto your sheet with your line paste. Again, you just want to make sure that you have nice clean lines with no breaks in the lines so that when you're painting, the paint doesn't seep through. Once you've finished lining in your design, you want to let that sit and dry for 24 to 48 hours just so it's nice and dry before you start painting. Once your lines are dry, you want to pop your sheet onto a piece of cardboard so that you got a bit more freedom to move your sheet around. And then it's time to mix the paints. You want to start with a small bowl and a pea size amount of paint in each. If you're mixing two colors like I have here, pink and white, or red and white to make pink, you want to mix that color before you add the water, just so you can make sure that you get an even consistency and the colors correct before you start putting in the paint. Start putting in the water. You're going to add 10 to 15 mils of water per little small bowl. 10 mils is about 2 teaspoons, so 2 to 3 teaspoons per paint color. And then you're going to thoroughly mix that so you've got a nice even consistency. Once you've completely mixed your paint and water together, the fun of painting begins. You want to work from the center of a area and work out. I tend to start with the yellow or the lightest color first. By starting in the center of an area and working out, you can control the rate of the paint bleeds, just making it a little bit easier to prevent any bleed out into other areas as you're working. You don't want to rush because that's when bleeding occurs. Just take your time and enjoy the process. The paints we're using now are Kitzer acrylic paints, and is the reason why you need to water them down. If you'd have used acrylic paints directly straight onto the fabric without watering them down, your fabric would become like cardboard, and then you wouldn't be able to use the sheets as gift wrapping once you've finished your artwork. I found that I need another colour, so I've just made a purple from the leftover pink. I'm feeling that my umbrellas are too solid, so I thought I'd add a bit of purple to the outside of the umbrella. Just starting in from the line, I added the purple, allowing the paint to bleed. If your paint is a little bit too runny or too watery, it will bleed a lot more, so you do need to find that right consistency. So I found that I needed another colour, so I just added a little bit of white to the purple that I already had. I'll add a little bit more water because I've added more paint just to keep that consistency right. And I'm just going to paint the stockings purple. So to finish off, I didn't want to paint the whole background blue, but I did want to add something to it. So I want to add some raindrops. I'm just on a scrap of piece of fabric. I just thought of practice painting raindrops. So I just wanted to want a thin line. So just about find that right consistency and technique to dash those raindrops in. Dry, you're just going to wash out your lines. Some will need a little bit of scrubbing, other times it'll just fall off. Just go around, make sure that all the line paste is washed away. Once all your lines have been washed away, let that dry. So there's the finished project. I thought I'd just quickly show you how I wrap presents. So turn it over. Small box on the angle. One present.